Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're solving single linear inequalities where the x coefficient is negative. Let's start with something I need you super good at for this particular video. I need you to be able to solve linear equations where we have a negative x coefficient, like the following two examples here. We've done that back in linear equations. Pause the video and make sure you can do this. Now hopefully you got the answers. X is equal to negative 6 and x is equal to positive 10. If you're looking at that and thinking, I have no idea why they're the answers or I made a mistake, you've got to go back to your building blocks with solving linear equations where the x coefficient is negative. If you have got it right, we're ready to solve these linear inequalities where the x is negative. We do very, very similar to how we solve linear equations. We just have to be super careful of the negative coefficients. There's a little trick that happens, and I'll introduce you to that now. So, to explain the idea and how it comes about, I've written six inequality statements there. I've written the same one six times. Two is less than six. And I'm going to perform operations to both sides and see if we preserve the inequality. So the first thing I'm going to do is add. That's the most obvious thing. Let me add two to both sides. What do I get when I do that? On the left hand side I get 4, on the right hand side I get myself 8, and it is true that 4 is strictly less than 8. So I have been able to preserve the inequality sign there. I've been able to just write down the same one. Now I've checked adding, let's check subtracting. So we're going to subtract 2 off both sides, write down what we get. I get 0, I get 4 here, and it is true that 0 is less than 4. 0 is here, 4 is here, so 4 is more to the right, so 4 is bigger, or you could think of it as 0 is more to the left, so 0 is smaller. Okay. Now, I've checked add and subtract, better check multiply, hadn't I? Let's multiply by positive 2. Why don't we multiply both sides by positive 2? On the left hand side I'll get 4, on the right hand side I'll get 12, and it is true that 4 is less than 12, we all know that. I've checked add, subtract, multiply, let's check divide. I'm going to divide both sides by positive 2. What will I get? I'll get 1 on this side, I'll get 3 on this side, and 1 is strictly less than 3. You will notice that in all the cases, when I've added to both sides, when I've subtracted from both sides, when I've multiplied both sides by a positive number and divided both sides by a positive number, I've kept the inequality sign going the same way. The only thing I need to check, guys, is multiplying and dividing by negative numbers. Let's see what happens there. Say if I multiply both sides by negative 2. Let's just carefully think what I get. 2 multiplied by negative 2 is negative 4. 6 multiplied by negative 2 is negative 12. Negative 4 is here. Negative 12 is way down here somewhere, isn't it? Negative 12. Negative 4 is actually bigger than negative 12, isn't it? It's more to the right on the number line. It's closer to 0. It's a bigger number than negative 12. So we're in a bit of a different situation here. We have had to reverse the inequality sign there when we multiply by a negative number. Let's see what happens when we divide by a negative number. Let's divide both sides by negative 2. See if the same applies. Well, 2 divided by negative 2 is negative 1. 6 divided by negative 2 is negative 3. And let's just quickly draw those here. Negative 1 is here. Negative 3 is here. And negative 1 is certainly bigger than negative 3. It is more to the right on the number line. So again, we'd have to swap or reverse the inequality sign there. So our original inequality, when we divided both sides by a negative number, was actually we had to swap the inequality. And this is always a rule for us to apply. So when we have, when we do multiplying or dividing by a negative number, we must swap the inequality sign. So let's write that down. When you are multiplying or dividing by a negative number, you must swap the inequality sign or reverse the inequality sign. Okay, and that is a rule we're going to need to apply and think really carefully about when we see these scenarios. So I've got a couple of questions for you where you may have to multiply or divide by negative numbers. Let's see if we can get the right answers. At each stage, pause the video and have a go. Here's the first one. Solve the following. Well, I have negative 2x is less than positive 12. I want to get x by itself, so I'm going to divide both sides by negative 2 to remove that multiply by negative 2. On the left hand side, I do get x. On the right hand side, positive 12 divided by negative 2 is negative 6. I have divided by a negative number. I must remember to reverse the inequality sign. And that x on its own here is the answer. X is bigger than negative 6 is our set of answers. Let's try one more. Make sure you pause the video, have a go yourself. Solve 7 subtract 3x is bigger than 11. Okay, I need x by itself, let's say on the left hand side. Let me subtract 7 off both sides. And that would leave me on the right hand side with 4 over here. On this side, it would leave me with negative 3x, and I have subtracted 7 off both sides. That doesn't reverse the inequality sign. I would get that. But now is where a little difficulty comes. To undo multiplying by negative 3, I'm going to divide both sides by negative 3. Now, on the left hand side, I will get the x I'm looking for. Positive 4 divided by negative 3 is overall a negative answer, and we can just write 4 thirds, leave it as an improper. Because I have divided both sides by negative, I must remember to swap the inequality sign, and the answer is x strictly less than negative 4 thirds. And that's it for this particular skill. Thanks loads for watching.